Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about some important root modifications. Okay, yesterday we completed storage roots and we started epiphytic roots. Which roots? Epiphytic roots. Now we are going to continue that epiphytic roots, right? Number two. Epiphytic roots. Now see this diagram. Sir, this is branch of a tall tree. On this branch of a tall tree, epiphytes are present, right? This is a epiphyte, okay? Now this epiphyte contains how many types of roots? Two types of roots. These epiphytes having how many types of roots? Two types of roots. Two types of roots. What are the two types of roots, sir? First one is clinging roots or clinging roots. Clinging roots. And second one is velamen roots, right? Up to here we discussed yesterday, right? Now listen here. Sir, in case of which plants? Epiphytes. In epiphytes, roots are dimorphic. What are dimorphic, sir? Roots are dimorphic. It means here dimorphic roots are present. Means morphologically two types of roots are present. Is it okay? Sir, what are the two types of roots, sir? First one is clinging roots. And second one is velamen roots. What is the second one? Velamen roots. Go for the first one. Sir, these clinging roots are short. See the diagram? Whereas velamen roots are long. Therefore, clinging roots are short and branched. Whereas velamen roots, they are long and branched. Sir, what these clinging roots do, sir? They fixes the epiphyte on the branch of the tall tree. So what is the function of clinging roots? Fixation. They fixes what? Epiphyte. Where? On the branch of the tall tree, right? Therefore, clinging roots are short and branched. What they do, sir? Fixes epiphyte on branch. Is this statement okay? Right. Now go for velamen roots. Sir, these are velamen roots, right? They are long and branched and they hangs in the air. Therefore, they are aerial, right? What they are? Aerial. They are aerial. They are adventitious. What they are? Adventitious, right? And hangs in the air. Hangs in air. Now, listen to this statement. Sir, we are discussing which roots, sir? Velamen roots. Which roots, sir? Velamen roots. Sir, this velamen roots contains a dead hygroscopic hygroscopic tissue. This velamen roots contains a dead hygroscopic tissue. This dead hygroscopic tissue is called as a velamen tissue. What is called as velamen tissue? Statement is important. Sir, velamen roots are living roots, but the tissue, which tissue? Velamen tissue is a dead tissue. Sir, hygroscopic. What is the meaning of hygroscopic, sir? Ability to absorb water. Ability to absorb water and lose water. That is called as what, sir? Hygroscopic. Is it okay? Right. Therefore, velamen roots contains a dead hygroscopic tissue called as which tissue, sir? Velamen tissue. Which tissue? Velamen tissue. Due to the presence of velamen tissue, due to the presence of velamin tissue. In which roots? Velamin roots. Velamin roots absorbs moisture from atmosphere. What they absorbs? They absorbs moisture from atmosphere. Who is absorbing moisture from atmosphere, sir? Velamin roots. Due to the presence of what? Velamin tissue. Is this statement okay? Right? Therefore, due to the presence of which tissue? Velamin tissue. Due to the presence of velamin tissue, right? Velamin roots absorbs what, sir? Moisture. Absorbs moisture from where, sir? Absorbs moisture from atmosphere by imbibition process. These words are important. You should be careful with these words, right? Therefore, sir, due to the presence of velamin tissue, right, the velamin roots absorbs what? Moisture from atmosphere. By which process, sir? Imbibition process. Sir, what is the meaning of imbibition? Absorption of water by hydrophilic colloids is called as imbibition. Absorption of water, okay, by hydrophilic colloids is called as imbibition. Is these statements clear? Right? Now you tell me, sir, velamin roots, they are absorbing what? Moisture from atmosphere. But is the amount of moisture same in the atmosphere throughout the year? No. Is this epiphyte in contact with the soil directly? No. It is on the branch of a tall tree. Yes or no? Epiphytes, they are on the branches of tall trees. It means epiphytes are not in direct contact with the soil. Epiphytes are not in direct contact with the soil. Therefore, epiphytes shows xerophytic adaptations. Epiphytes shows which adaptations? Xerophytic adaptations. So, all epiphytes are xerophytes. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, as epiphytes are not in direct contact. They are not in direct contact with soil. No continuous supply of water. Is there continuous supply of water? No. No continuous supply of water. Is this statement okay? Sir, epiphytes, they are not in direct contact with the soil. Is it okay? Right. So what happens? So no continuous supply of water. So what? Epiphytes. So epiphytes are xerophytes. Epiphytes are what, sir? Xerophytes. Does it mean that all xerophytes are epiphytes? No. But all epiphytes are xerophytes. All epiphytes are xerophytes. But all xerophytes are not epiphytes. Is this statement okay? Right? Right. What is the statement? All epiphytes are what, sir? Xerophytes. But all xerophytes are not epiphytes. Is this statement okay? Take Opuntia, take cactus. Sir, cactus is a xerophyte. Does it mean that cactus is an epiphyte? No. Cactus is a xerophyte, but it is not on the branch of a tall tree. So can we call Opuntia, that is cactus, as an epiphyte? No, but Opuntia is a xerophyte. Therefore, all xerophytes are not epiphytes. Is it okay? Right? Sir, in epiphytes, root hairs are absent. Absence of root hair is compensated by velamen tissue. Right? Absence of what, sir? Root hairs. Absence of root hairs compensated by which tissue? Velamen tissue. Sir, generally root hair, what it does? Absorbs water. Now here root hairs are absent in case of epiphytes. Then who is absorbing water? Velamen tissue. Yes or no? Therefore, absence of root hair is compensated by velamen tissue. Is it okay? Now go for examples of epiphytic roots. Examples of epiphytic roots. Number one, vanda. What are the first example? Vanda. Second example is teneophyllum or teneophyllum. Teneophyllum or teneophyllum. These two are examples for epiphytic roots. Sir, these two are epiphytes means automatically these two becomes what, sir? Xerophytes. Because all epiphytes are xerophytes. Therefore, vanda and teneophyllum, these two contains epiphytic roots. These two contains which roots, sir? Epiphytic roots. Now you tell me, sir, in case of epiphytes, how many type of roots? Two types. What and what? Clinging roots and velamen roots. Which are hanging roots here? Velamen roots are hanging roots. What are hanging roots here? Velamen roots are hanging roots. They freely hangs in the air. So they are hanging roots. Is it okay? Right? Now go for the next root modification. What, sir? Photosynthetic roots. Number three, right? Which roots, sir? Photosynthetic roots. Tell me, sir, generally root, it is non-green in color. It is non-chlorophyllous. But I'm speaking about photosynthetic roots. It means here root has to perform photosynthesis. To perform photosynthesis, root should contain chlorophyll. Yes or no? What should contain chlorophyll? Root should contain chlorophyll. But if chlorophyll is present, it should be what in color? Green in color. Therefore, photosynthetic roots are green. Right. Chlorophyllous. Green. Chlorophyllous roots. Green chlorophyllous roots. What they performs? Which performs photosynthesis. Sir, photosynthesis can be called even as carbon assimilation. Photosynthesis is also called as carbon assimilation. Is it okay? So these photosynthetic roots are also called as assimilatory roots. What is another name for photosynthetic roots, sir? Assimilatory roots. Photosynthetic roots are also called as assimilatory roots. Is this statement okay? Right. Now you tell me, generally in a plant, who performs photosynthesis? Leaf performs photosynthesis. But here, who is performing photosynthesis? Root is performing photosynthesis. It means root has taken over the function of leaf. The function which has to be performed by the leaf. What is that function? Photosynthesis. Here, who is performing? Root. Therefore, root takes over the function
of leaf. What is that function? That is photosynthesis. That is what, sir? photosynthesis, photosynthesis.
Is this statement okay? Right. Now, sir, we are discussing which roots, sir? Photosynthetic roots. Now, go for examples of photosynthetic roots. Examples of photosynthetic roots. First one is teleophyllum or teleophyllum. Second one is tenospora. What is the second one, sir? Tenospora. And third one is trapa. Therefore, teleophyllum, tenospora and trapa, these three are examples for which roots, sir? Photosynthetic roots. Okay, go for the first example. What it is? Teleophyllum. Teleophyllum. Now listen here, sir, in case of teleophyllum, shoot system, which system? Shoot system is highly reduced. Shoot system highly reduced. Sir, shoot system means nothing but stem, leaf, branches, flower, fruit. Stem, leaf, branches, flower, fruits. All this comes under which system, sir? Shoot system. Shoot system is highly reduced. That's why your complete plant, teleophyllum plant, is represented by roots. It means teleophyllum plant. What you can see clearly? Only roots. Why, sir? Because the total shoot system is highly reduced. Therefore, plant is represented by total plant. I am speaking about teleophyllum plant, right? Total plant or complete plant is represented by what, sir? Complete plant is represented by roots. Is it okay? Right. Sir, teleophyllum, it is a epiphyte, sir. Teleophyllum is a epiphyte. Sir, all epiphytes are xerophytes. I already told you, all epiphytes are xerophytes. I am saying that teleophyllum is an epiphyte. So, automatically, teleophyllum becomes a xerophyte. Teleophyllum becomes a xerophyte. Now, you tell me, sir, epiphyte means it should contain how many types of roots? Two types of roots. I am speaking about teleophyllum plant. Teleophyllum is a epiphyte. So, teleophyllum should contain how many types of roots? Two types of roots. Right. Teleophyllum. Teleophyllum roots. How many types they are? Two types. What and what, sir? First one is clinging roots. Okay. Second one is velamen roots. What is the second one, sir? Velamen roots. Is it okay? Right. Sir, this velamen roots are green, chlorophyllous and photosynthetic. I am speaking about teleophyllum plant. In teleophyllum plant, which roots are photosynthetic? Velamen roots. Therefore, velamen roots are green. They are chlorophyllous and they are photosynthetic. Velamen roots are photosynthetic. Is this statement okay? Clear? Right. Sir, during photosynthesis, a plant has to absorb carbon dioxide and what, sir? Carbon dioxide and water. Yes or no? Sir, here velamen roots means contains velamen tissue. Velamen tissue is already absorbing what from the moisture? What from the atmosphere? Absorbing moisture from the atmosphere. Now, these velamen roots are even performing photosynthesis. It means they have to absorb what? Carbon dioxide from atmosphere. Yes or no? Therefore, velamen roots absorbs carbon dioxide and moisture. Carbon dioxide and moisture. From where, sir? From atmosphere. Is this statement okay? Sir, take teleophyllum plant. In teleophyllum plant, velamen roots are green. They are chlorophyllous. They are photosynthetic. Is it okay? Actually, velamen roots means they absorb moisture from atmosphere. But in case of teleophyllum, velamin roots, as they are photosynthetic, they are not only absorbing moisture from atmosphere, but also absorbs carbon dioxide from atmosphere, carbon dioxide from atmosphere. Is these statements clear? Okay, right? Now go for the second example of photosynthetic roots. What it is? Tenospora. Go for the second example for photosynthetic roots. What it is, sir? Tenospora. Go for what, sir? Tenospora. Sir, this Tenospora is a lichen. Sir, what is the meaning of lichen, sir? Lichen means they are woody climbers. Lichens means what, sir? Woody climbers. Now, sir, what is the meaning of woody climbers, sir? For example, this is a support. What it is, sir? This is a support. For example, this is a support, sir. This is a support. Now listen here. Sir, here one weak stem is present. See how the stem is? Stem is weak. Is it okay? Right? Therefore, this white one is a support, whereas this yellow one, right, it is a weak stem. Once this weak stem coils around the support, this weak stem becomes woody. Sir, weak stem has coiled around the support. Once this weak stem coils around the support, then weak stem becomes woody. Such type of climbers are called as woody climbers. They are called as lichens. L-I-A-N-E-S. Lichens. Is this statement okay? Therefore, lichens means woody climbers. What is the meaning of woody climbers? Are they climbing a wood? No. First, the weak stem coils around the support. Once weak stem coils around the support, the weak stem becomes woody. Such climbers are called as woody climbers or lichens. Now see here, sir, this right of a Tenospora. This is a stem of what, sir? Tenospora. Stem means differentiated into what and what, sir? Nodes and internodes. Sir, this indicates node or internode? Node. From this nodal region during rainy season. From which region? Nodal region. From the nodes of the stem during rainy season, roots are developed. Sir, can I call these roots as aerial roots? Yes, these are aerial roots. And moreover, they are adventitious. These are aerial, these are adventitious roots. Sir, these roots are developed from where, sir? Developed from nodes of the stem. Developed from nodes of the stem. When, sir? During rainy season. During which season, sir? Rainy season. These roots are photosynthetic roots. What are these roots, sir? Photosynthetic roots. These are photosynthetic roots. Is this statement okay? Therefore, in case of Tenospora, photosynthetic roots are aerial. Photosynthetic roots are adventitious. They are developed from nodes of the stem. When, sir? During rainy season. During which season, sir? Rainy season. This is the second example. What it is, sir? Tenospora. Now go for the third example. What it is? Trapa. Sir, Trapa is a hydrophyte. But hydrophytes are of how many types? I already told you, hydrophytes are of 5 types. Sir, this is a, which type of hydrophyte, sir? It is a rooted hydrophyte with floating leaves. Rooted hydrophyte. Trapa is a rooted hydrophyte with what, sir? Floating leaves. Rooted hydrophyte with a floating leaves. Trapa is a rooted hydrophyte with a floating leaves. Is it okay? Right. Sir, in case of trapa, right, how the photosynthetic roots are? In case of trapa, photosynthetic roots. Which roots, sir? Photosynthetic roots are submerged. Submerged means present inside the water. Submerged, adventitious. What, sir? Submerged and adventitious. Therefore, photosynthetic roots of Ctenospora, aerial, adventitious. Photosynthetic roots of Trapa, submerged, adventitious. Therefore, in Ctenospora, photosynthetic roots are aerial. In Trapa, photosynthetic roots are submerged. Is this statement okay? Clear? Now listen this statement. Sir, in case of Ctenospora and Trapa, in case of what and what, sir? In case of Ctenospora and Trapa, right, in what and what? Ctenospora and Trapa, leaf performs photosynthesis, root also performs photosynthesis. Therefore, both root and leaves performs what? Photosynthesis. Is this statement okay? In case of which plants? In case of Ctenospora and Trapa, in case of Ctenospora and Trapa, root performs photosynthesis, even leaves also performs a photosynthesis. Is this statement clear? Okay, right? Therefore, these are photosynthetic roots. Now listen this statement. Sir, Trapa is commonly called as, the common name of Trapa is water chestnut. Water chestnut. What is the common name of Trapa? Water chestnut. Water chestnut. Right? Now go for the next root modification. Go for the next root modification. That is respiratory roots. Number 4. Respiratory roots. Sir, these respiratory roots are also called as breathing roots, right? Also called as breathing roots. They are also called as nematophores. P is silent. Here P is silent, right? P is a silent nematophores. Okay. Therefore, respiratory roots, also called as breathing roots, are nematophores. Is it okay? Right. Now, listen here. Listen these statements. Sir, for example, this is surface of the soil, sir. What is this one? Surface of the soil. Sir, this is a stem, sir. And this is a root. Is it okay? It means now where is the root, sir? Root is in the soil. Root requires oxygen for respiration. Root, what it requires? Requires oxygen for respiration. Normally, a root absorbs oxygen from the soil. Sir, why root requires oxygen for respiration? Root has to respire. For respiration, what it requires? Oxygen. The oxygen what a root requires, the root is taking that oxygen from where, sir? The root is taking that oxygen from the soil. From the soil. Is this statement okay? Right? Therefore, normally root
absorbs what? Oxygen from soil for respiration. For what, sir? Respiration. Now, listen to this statement. Take a mangrove plants. Which plants, sir? Mangrove plants. Take mangrove plants. Mangrove plants means the plants which grows in a saline. Saline. Swampy areas near sea shore. Is this statement okay? I'm speaking about which plants, sir? Mangrove plants. Which plants, sir? Mangrove plants. Mangrove plants generally grows right where? They grows in a saline swampy areas. Where you can see this saline swampy area, sir? Near sea shore. Sir, saline means which water? Salt water. Saline means which water, sir? Salt water. It means the soil is filled with which water, sir? Salt water. For example, right. Soil is filled with which water, sir? Salt water. This total is a salt water. Salt water. Soil is filled with salt water, right? Now listen to the statement. Now see this root. Sir, this is a tap root, right? What is another name for tap root, sir? Primary root. Tap root is also called as which root, sir? Primary root. Now see this diagram. Sir, this tap root or primary root is present in the soil which is filled with salt water. Yes or no? Which is filled with what, sir? Salt water. It means here condition is waterlogged condition. Waterlogged means soil is filled with water. So I am calling this condition as waterlogged condition. As the soil is filled with water, root won't get sufficient amount of oxygen. Root is not getting sufficient amount of oxygen. Root is not getting sufficient amount of oxygen. So what happens means this tap root means primary root. Sir, this primary root produces what, sir? Secondary roots. Secondary roots, how they grows? Horizontally or obliquely? See, here the secondary roots are growing horizontally. These are which roots, sir? These are secondary roots growing horizontally. From these secondary roots, what are developed, sir? Branches are developed. Sir, see these branches. These branches are growing. These branches are growing upwards or downwards. These branches are growing in upward manner. Is these statements okay? Sir, these are what? These are root branches. These are root branches developed from secondary roots. Sir, root branches developed from secondary roots, we should call them as which roots, sir? Tertiary roots. Yes or no? Sir, this is tap root, primary root. Produced branch, what is that branch? Becomes a secondary root. Secondary root produced a branch. Therefore, what is that root branch called as? A tertiary root. Is it okay? Right. Now, this becomes which root, sir? Tertiary root. Is it okay? Right. Now, the tip of this tertiary root, tip of the tertiary root contains pores, pores. Right. These pores are called as a nematode. What are these pores called as, sir? Nematode. Nematode also called as a lenticel. What is another name for nematode, sir? Lenticel. Nematode also called as lenticel. Now you see this diagram carefully. Sir, this is a root branch having nematodes at its tip. Yes or no? This root branch which bears nematodes at their tip, that root branch becomes a respiratory root. That root branch becomes what, sir? Respiratory root or breathing root or nematophore. Is this statement okay? Clear? Now see here. It means now this branch came to the surface of the soil. So through this pores, P-O-R-E-S, through this pores, it takes oxygen from the atmosphere. Takes what, sir? Oxygen from the atmosphere. This oxygen goes to secondary roots. That oxygen again enters into the primary root. Therefore, from tertiary root to secondary root, from secondary root to primary root, what has moved, sir? Oxygen has moved. Is this statement okay? Therefore, through this nematode, sir, right, oxygen enters into the root. Is it okay? Now, root is going to respire. During respiration, it is utilizing which gas? Oxygen. Releases which gas? Carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide moves from primary root to secondary root to tertiary root, and comes right out of the root through what, sir? Comes out of the root through nematodes or lenticels. Yes or no? It means exchange of gases takes place through these nematodes. Exchange of gases takes place through nematodes. Sir, nematodes are also called as what? Lenticel. These lenticels not only used for exchange of gases but also used for transpiration process. Lenticels not only used for exchange of gases but also helps in what, sir? Transpiration, but also helps in transpiration process. Is this statement clear? Okay, right. Now listen to the statements. This is a nematode, right? Now listen to the statements. In which plants, sir? Mangrove plants. In mangrove plants, that is plants which grows in plants which grows in what? Saline swampy areas, right? As soil is waterlogged means soil is filled with water. Soil is filled with what? Water. H2O means water, right? Therefore, as soil is filled with what, sir? Water. Therefore, soil is waterlogged. Root does not get sufficient amount of oxygen. Who is not getting sufficient amount of oxygen? Root. Why, sir? Because the soil is waterlogged. Soil is waterlogged. Root is not getting sufficient amount of oxygen. So what happens? Horizontal cables of roots means nothing but which roots, sir? Secondary roots. Produced from tap roots. Horizontal cables of root, what these horizontal cables of root does? Produces what? Root branches. What they produce as? Root branches. We are calling these root branches as which roots? Tertiary roots. Is it okay? Right? Sir, what happens to these root branches? These root branches grows upwards or downwards? Grows upwards. Sir, growing upwards means in which manner, sir? Growing upwards means in which manner they are growing? Positively phototrophic manner. or negatively geotrophic manner. Generally, root grows in which manner, sir? Root grows in positively geotrophic manner. But here root is growing in which manner? Negatively geotrophic manner. Is this statement clear? It grows in either positively phototrophic manner, nothing but negatively geotrophic manner. Therefore, this root branches grows upwards in positively phototrophic manner or negatively geotrophic manner. What are these branches called as? These branches called respiratory roots or breathing roots or nematophores. What, sir? Nematophores. The tips of these nematophores tip of nematophore contains pores. What are these pores called as? Pores called as a, what sir? Nematodes. What is another name for nematodes? Lenticels. Nematodes are also called as what sir? Lenticels. Is it okay? Right? Now we are discussing about what sir? Nematodes, right? Sir, what is the function of this nematode, sir? Number one, exchange of gases. Nematodes helps in what, sir? Exchange of gases. Number two, also helps in transpiration. Also helps in what? Transpiration. What is the meaning of transpiration? Loss of water in the form of vapors from aerial parts of the plant. What is lost? Water is lost in the form of what? Vapors. That process is called as transpiration. Loss of water in the form of vapors from aerial parts of a plant is called as a transpiration. Therefore, nematodes helps in exchange of gases and what, sir? Transpiration. Is this statement okay? Now listen to this statement. Sir, only the tip of the nematophore contains nematodes. Yes or no? Right. Remaining. What? Remaining part of a nematophore. I'm speaking about nematophore, right? Remaining part of nematophore covered by cork. Is it okay? Therefore, remaining part of nematophore is covered by what, sir? Cork. Remaining part of nematophore is covered by what, sir? Cork. Is it okay? Right. Now go for examples of respiratory roots. Examples of respiratory roots. First one is rhizophora. Rhizophora. Second one is Avicennia. What is the second example, sir? Avicennia. Sir, this Rhizophora and Avicennia both are mangrove plants. Rhizophora and Avicennia both are which plants? Mangrove plants. Now I am writing the third example. It's Jassia. What is the third example, sir? Jassia. Sir, this Jassia, it is not a mangrove plant. Therefore, it is a non-mangrove plant. It is not a mangrove plant. But it is with respiratory roots. Therefore, Jassia is a non-mangrove plant with respiratory roots. Jassia is a non-mangrove plant with what, sir? Respiratory roots. Here we are having some important points concerned to Jassia. What they are? Listen. What is the example? Jassia. Sir, Jassia, it is a non-mangrove plant. It is not a mangrove plant, right? It is a non-mangrove plant. Sir, it is a free-floating hydrophyte. Hydrophytes are of five types, right? This comes under which hydrophyte? It is a free-floating hydrophyte. Free-floating hydrophyte. Sir, in case of Jassia, respiratory roots are spongy. What are spongy? Respiratory roots are spongy. In case of which plant? Jassia. therefore spongy respiratory roots are present in the case of Jessia. Sir, these spongy respiratory roots of Jessia performs two functions. Performs how many functions? Two functions. Therefore, spongy respiratory roots of Jessia are dual in function. Sir, dual means how many functions? Two functions. Sir, what are the two functions, sir? First one, exchange of gases. What is the first function? Exchange of gases. Second function is helps in floating of a plant. Helps in floating of the plant. See here, in case of Jessia, respiratory roots are spongy. What is the use of respiratory roots? Exchange of gases. Yes or no? Right. Here, respiratory roots are spongy. As a root is spongy, it makes the plant to float on the surface of the water. Who is making the plant to float on the surface of the water? Spongy respiratory roots of Jessia. Therefore, spongy respiratory roots are dual in function, performs two functions. One is exchange of gases and second one is helps in floating of the plant on the water surface. Floating of the plant on the water surface. In physics, we are going to call this nature as buoyancy. Right, therefore, spongy respiratory roots of Jessia provides buoyancy to the plant. Provides what? Buoyancy to the plant. Is it okay? Right? Tomorrow we'll continue the remaining part. Is it okay? Right? Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.